Because you know I'm all about that bass, about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, 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 bass. Yeah, it's pretty clear, I ain't no size 2, but I can shake it like I'm supposed to do. Cause I got that boom boom that all the boys chase, and all the right junk in all the right places. I see the magazine working out Photoshop. We know that shit ain't real, come on now make it stop. If you got beauty, beauty, just raise them up. Cause every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top. Yeah, my mama, she told me don't worry about your size.
Hi everyone, welcome to the Little Blue Fish Podcast. I am your host, Nicole, and today is November the 11th, 2014. Before I get into anything else, I would like to give a huge, huge, huge thank you to everyone who liked, comment, rated, subscribed to, you know, the podcast on YouTube, said nice things about the podcast, got in touch with me personally on Ravelry, PM'd me, whatever it may be, and I got word of it. Thank you so much. Like, I have been just so touched by the knitting community. You guys are amazing. You guys are awesome, really. And that you guys have just touched my heart. Last time I checked, I think it was like 120 plus views. I would be happy if I only got 2, but you guys, you know, took the time out of your day to watch me, you know, said nice things about it and, you know, what I could do in the future and all that kind of stuff. So I greatly appreciate it. So I want to get my thank yous out the way in the beginning this time. Moving on, I do want to talk about some administrative stuff with you, some administrative things. So one being, you might have seen my face under another podcast. And the reason for that, I was previously knitting Sweet Pea, and I was trying to upload the video or the podcast on iTunes. I was having some kind of problem. Supposedly, there's already something with that name. And I was searching. I'm like, okay, I'm not getting anything with that name. So I don't know why I couldn't upload it. But anyways, I wanted to keep everything the same. So when I originally changed my name, when I started the podcast, I was Bluefish Knits on Ravelry. And I like that name, you know, I really like the name, so I tried to stick with it. I wasn't able to get my, you know, original username back, but that's okay. However, on Ravelry, you can find me as Fancy Blue Fish. On Instagram and Twitter, you can find me as Fancy Blue. If you need to email me for any reason, I did set up an email address specifically for the podcast, and that email address is fancybluefish@gmail.com. I think that was about it when it came to anything being administrative. So I'm also on YouTube as Little Blue Fish. Banners and badges. As you can see, if you head on over to the Ravelry group, I did set up a new one under this name. I think I got everything set up. I'm just worried about the whole iTunes thing. If I don't get to be up on iTunes, it's fine. It's not a big deal. You can always locate me on YouTube and the blog. I don't have a banner. You know, if you head over to the Ravelry group, I don't have a banner or a badge. And that being, I don't know how to create one. So if you would like to, or you know someone that would like to, you know, create a badge or a banner for the podcast, please let me know, because I have no idea how to do it. I see everybody with their nice little badge and banner associated with their podcast, and I would like to get mine up and running with the podcast. The design features get that squared away with the podcast. As you can see, if you head on over to the blog, I do have a nice background that goes along with the name of the podcast. So, you know, if you have, you know, some creative ideas for the podcast concerning the badge and banner, please let me know. Just feel free to PM me on Ravelry. That's probably the best way that you can get in touch with me. So I think that was it. Beware, there is a lot of knitting in this episode. So I'm very happy to show you. So let's go ahead and dive in. First, I want to start off with some finished objects. I have a whopping 5 finished objects. My foes, you guys. That's a lot. That's a lot of knitting. So, first up, back in the previous episode, I was knitting on my chunky button cowl. It is completed. Well, 3 buttons shy of being completed. I need to block it as well. This is it. This is what it looks like. It's just a plain rectangle. You first cast on a certain amount of stitches, you knit straight, bind off, and then you come to the sides and pick up these stitches to create the ribbing, do your buttonholes, cast off. So I love the yarn. It is so squishy and soft. I need to block it, so I will soon get the materials to do so. I might just steam block it instead of wet block it. So yeah, that's going to be nice and cozy under my winter coat. So I was excited to get this off the needles. This was knit on my Knitter's Pride's US size 10, 6.0 millimeter. The yarn is Malabrigo Mecca. I forgot the colorway. If you're interested, just check my project notes on Ravelry. And the pattern is the Chunky Button Cowl by Tracy Muir. And the colorway is On Point. It's nice and fally, great for fall. The colors are really pretty. You've got some, you know, some greens, some blues, browns, you know, burnt orange, all fall colors. And it just turned out really, really nice. So I'll give you a close-up of the stitch pattern. So that's what the yarn looks like up close. And sorry for my ends. They have been woven in. I just need to block it before I clip the ends. So that's finished object number one. Finished object number two. You guys remember I was knitting a dress for my daughter, and I did. This is the second time it turned out a little bit smaller than I expected, which is okay. It fits her like a tunic, so it comes right below her tush, so I figured she can wear tights with it, or she can wear like a long sleeve shirt, being that it's, you know, a little bit cooler. But this is the dress. That's what it looks like. And it's got some, you know, eyelet detailing up here where the arms, where you increase for the armholes or the sleeves, my bad. And then eyelet detailing for the, where the ribbon goes. And this pattern is the Ribbon Dress by Ray Pocket. I mentioned in the last episode that I had trouble reading this pattern. It was very poorly written. And, I had to rewrite part of the pattern for me to understand it. Thank God I'm familiar with raglan top-down sweaters. Because if I'm not, I don't think I would be able to get through the pattern. So the yarn is Cascade 220 Superwash Sport. I think the colorway number is 221. And I knit this on a US size 6, 4.0 millimeter. And I will have to upload a picture on Ravelry of it completed, because on Ravelry I just had my daughter. I drew my daughter and like it's like half done, so like it's half on her. I was just making sure that it fit. But I probably will knit this again in DK or worsted, so it could be just a little bit bigger. But that's the only other issue I had. I think it'll be fine once I block it. It should be fine. Now, I did bind off a little tight, so I might rip that out and do like a stretchy bind off, or just, my best bet is to probably bind off maybe 2 sizes bigger, and then do a stretchy bind off on top of it, so it won't be so tight. But I'll fix that later. It'll take probably about 15-20 minutes to do. So, finished object number 2. And my other one fell on the floor. This is the Zuzu's Petals pattern. And someone very kindly gifted to me this pattern. And I have forgotten who it was. So I do apologize, you know, if you're watching this episode and She's like, hey, I gifted her that. I do apologize, but thank you so much. I do greatly appreciate the pattern. The pattern is right here. This is a picture of it. I guess I should take it out the cover. This is a pattern. That's what it looks like. Yeah, isn't that pretty? And then look at all the color. I like that color transition. It's so pretty. I will probably knit this again. And probably a gradient so I can get the same effect. But here, I knit mine in all one solid color. And this is what it looks like. Again, forgive me, none of these items are blocked. I was just whipping things off the needle because I can't. Well, actually, I'll talk about later on in the episode how I was able to get all this knitting done. So this is what mine looks like. And it was an interesting construction. I would have never thought you could knit a cowl this way. I mean, most cowls are, you either start off in the round, you knit in the round the entire thing, or you knit it flat, then seam it together, or you know, do a three-needle bind off or something like that to have it in one form. Anyways, or in a circle. You guys know what I'm talking about. And this one, you start off here. This is right for my strays. This is where you start off in the beginning, and you start off with a garter tab. It is a paper pattern, so I don't think I'm giving away too much. You start off with a garter tab, and that's how you do it. You increase to a certain point, and then you join in the round. So I thought that was very interesting. And you knit it from the top down. This has actually got me hooked on lace linen, and I actually like working with sport weight yarn. I like the gauge that I achieved with this project. You can see, let me show you the lace pattern a little bit up close. So that is this one, and this is also knit on a US size 6, 4.0 millimeter. The yarn is Knit Picks Wool the Andes in the Mink Heather colorway. So that's it. One last time. And I think I'm not sure if I put this on. I think I put it as finished on my Ravelry page. I'm not sure if I did that. I'm bad about doing that. I don't know why. But I am. The other one, going before as well. This is so cute. This is adorable. This is my own pattern. It is a little mini stocking stuffer. Isn't that adorable? So I need to get a couple of these babies knocked out. But yeah, I had a little trouble with this pattern that I came up with, and you will see later on in the episode. But the yarn is just Red Heart Soft, and I just picked up a red color, then a green color, and white for the top. I think for all of them that I knit, I will keep white. I thought about doing different colors, but I want that to be the same. But it is so cute and mini. Yeah, it's just adorable, and I think it's so cute. And this will help me stay on budget when it comes to stuffing these things, because I know if I have one big giant stocking, that is going to probably run me $30, $40 to fill up. So those dollar things that you can get from Dollar Tree, dollar store, stuff like that, that's, you know, stuff that's like a dollar, it really adds up. Like, stockings can hold a lot of stuff. But yeah, I've already got my list for everybody that I need to get stocking stuffers for, and that will be fun when the time comes to stuff them and then hang them. For this one, that's all I need to complete is a little loop that goes at the top so I can hang either on the tree. I don't know if they want to put them on the tree, or they'll put it over their fireplace. You can do that way. But I'll probably give, when I give them their stocking stuffers, I will probably give them hooks as well, so that they can go ahead and hang them up. So that was finished object number 4. And the last one went somewhere. I'm curious. It is this one. It's another stocking stuffer. And it turned out a little big. This one I completed the little hook for it. This one will probably be mine or something like that. But it was turned out a little big because I have to knit so many. I thought this was too big of a gauge are too big of a stocking for me to knit. I think I need to knit 11. So, for me to knit 11, I don't think this was a good size. So, I wanted something just a little bit smaller. And you guys can see the difference. There you go. And all of it was, this one was knit, I think this was Karen Simply Saw. And the top of this one was, trying to think, I think it was Baroque Vintage Decay in the white, this white coloring. So that was this one. So that's all my finished objects that I had. That was quite a few. I'll put this over here. So next, I will move on to my WIPs, work in progress. So what I have on the needles, first up is my Mahoney Shawl by Melski, who has the With Mel podcast, formerly known as Single-Handed Knits. And she is just a joy to watch. She is so cute, first of all. And, you know, she's just very pleasant to just, you know, watch. Her voice is just so soothing. She sounds really nice. Even when I'm just, you know, out and about or, you know, cleaning my room or doing something and I can't really sit down and watch her podcast, I'll put her on and, you know, just listen to what she has to talk about. But I do apologize, I'm in the middle of a row. And this is what this looks like. I'm trying to get it where you can see the color. It's not really accurate. It's a little bit purplish, more purple than what it's showing up on the screen. But it is a shawlette. It's a crescent shawl. And this is also Knit on Knit Picks. Or Knit on USI 6 4.0 millimeters. These are my Knit Picks, and I'm using Knit Picks Stroll fingering weight yarn, and the colorway is Sprinkle Heather. This is what it looks like in the skein. But yeah, and that color, the way it's showing up now, is pretty accurate. So that's what it looks like. That's what's up first on my works in progress. Next project I have is a pair of socks. Wanted to get some socks on the needles. And I am knitting the Monkey Socks by Cookie A. And I am doing the No Purl version that was cleverly created by, I think it's Crafty Pancakes who came up with it. Oh no. I just knocked my stitches off the needles. Okay, there we go. That's what I get for not paying attention. But yeah. And I don't have a sock blocker, so I have to show you like this. Or better yet, I can pop it on my hand and show you. That's what it looks like. I'm trying to get it to focus here. Doesn't want to focus. I'm not sure why. Okay, my camera doesn't like me. But I'm sure you guys have seen this out numerous times. I wear a size 9.5. I'm knitting these. I'm following it. The last time I knit socks, they were pretty. They're pretty fine. They're pretty okay. They're pretty much okay. The heel was a little bit baggy, but that's all right. But I'm still doing it the traditional math for a sock is you knit it, I think, 2 inches before you stop at 2 inches before the total length of your foot. So that's what I'm doing, and then I'll pop in my waist yarn for my afterthought heel. I might even do a fishlets kids heel, which I'm hearing everybody's trying that out, so I might try that out and see how that works out for my foot. If I like it, I'll continue to use that heel. But I'm knitting these obviously toe up on. These are one size 1, US size 1 needles. These are the Hiya's. These are the original ones, the ones without the blue cable. And this is Jinx yarn. And I think it's Vanille colorway. It's spelled V-A-N-I-L-L-E. So that's what that looks like. Isn't that gorgeous? I love this yarn. And I also got some lovely pins. Miss Laura sent me some pins with the purchase of my yarn. This one pin, she is Laura of the Dyer's podcast, or Dyer's Notebook podcast. I love her. She's also very pleasant to watch. Everybody is. And this is the one for her yarns. So that's that. And then here's her card. Card information. And then it's got, her information on the back of the card. So that is that. Next up is my Central Park hoodie. I started this, I meant to tell you, the yarn, this is the, I'm not sure what base this is. I think it's single merino, and it is 400 yards. That's the only thing I forgot to tell you about that. I started my hoodie, I think it was back in 2012, I'm not mistaken. I think it was 2012, but it's actually in a book. I'm trying to show you that. I've already got the back completed. This is what it looks like. And it's in the Best of Knitting knitting book by Lisa Schroyer. Sorry if I butchered your name. A collection of simple, stylish, and spirited knits. And I'll show you another picture of it. But yeah. Here is a picture of the hoodie. Yeah, I think that is a really nice hoodie symbol. I've already completed the back. The entire back. And left 5 stitches for the hood, because I think you have to like pick up some stitches. I gotta read my notes, but I picked it back up right around the time I started podcasting, right after I started podcasting. So this is what I have done so far. And at the bottom, you can't really see my armholes, but they're there. And this is knit in Karen Simply Soft yarn, and I think the colorway was burgundy. I know I'm going to run out. I'm going to have to get some more. I haven't been able to find any, so I guess I'm going to have to look online. I got it from Walmart, so I'll either have to check Joann's or online if I can't find it anywhere else. Or I might check Hobby Lobby. I'm not sure if they sell Karen Simply Soft. I know they sell I Love This Yarn. That's their brand. But I'll worry about that another time. I picked it back up, and I was 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, because I counted the cables when I picked it back up. I started when I picked it back up for the sleeves. So I'm about maybe halfway through the sleeves. So that's what it looks like. And I'm knitting these on those Knitter's Prize, the ones that I don't really like. I won't say hate, but not the best knitting needles, but I'm managing. I use a US size 6 4.5 millimeter for the ribbing, and for the rest calls for a US size 8 5.0 millimeter. So that is that. Still got 2 more projects to show you. Nope, 3. 3 more works in progress to show you. It's the yarn sitting right beside me. So, next up is the stocking stuffers. I'm working on another one. This one I'm doing toe up. The first one I did top down. And top down socks is just not really for me. If I have to knit a sock top down, I prefer to knit the cuff flat and then join around. I hate trying to join around on magic loop, knitting the sock down, like top down. That just aggravates me. Toe up is the way I go on magic loop. So this one, I'm knitting toe up. So I cast on, I used a Turkish cast on, and I think it was, I cast on 8 stitches, and then I increased to 35, and I was doing that every other row. So I would increase, knit a row, increase. So I'm increasing 4 stitches each row, which I'm basically using the, is it I'm getting that confused with something else. It's the seam-free rounded toe is what I'm using, and using the Turkish cast on. So that's what I use, and I increase to 35. Now when I do, when it calls for my heel, you can see I already put in my waist yarn. I increased till I got my 35, and then I knit 2 inches, put in my waist yarn, and then I'm going to knit another 2 inches, and then put it in the different color. Start using the white for the top, and then go back and do my heel, which I'm just using a afterthought heel, a simple afterthought heel, and then I'll decrease. I follow the instructions as is, and decrease to 8 stitches, and then Kitchener stitch my heel. And it's really a no-brainer. This is my own pattern. Let's have that come up. Now, however, it wasn't that simple, because I thought that I could knit this stocking stuffer that is this size, knit 11 of these babies, and I was like, there's no way that this is going to happen. So I went down a size. No, I changed needles, because this is Karen Simply Soft, and I changed needles. I think I dropped down to I went to 7, so this one is knitted on 7s, and I dropped down, and I finished one. This is all knit on size 7s. I'm not sure how many stitches I cast on. I think this one has 40 stitches around. This one's knit top down, and it was still a little bit too big, and I was like, I kind of want something tinier so I can whip them out. So that's why I knitted this one, and I like the size of it. It's like so perfect. It's, look, you can set it like right next to your coffee cup. It's the same size. I think it is so cute, so adorable, and I will knit these in different colors. You can see the one I'm working on now. I'm doing with the reverse. I'm knitting it in the green. This one I did the green for the heel, and then this one, the entire sock in green, and then I'm going to do the red for the heel, then have the white at the top for the cuff. So I need to knit 11 of them, but if it, you know, push comes to shove and I don't get to knit all 11 of them like I need to, I will at least need to knit, I think, because Alex is 1, 4, 2. So I would need to knit 7, which I'm sure I can do with no problem. And then, you know, maybe go by the other remaining 4. For the adults, because there's 7 kids in all. So I just want to at least get the kids one. So, which I'm pretty sure will be no problem. But yeah, I really thought I could pop out 11 of these in this size. I'm like, that's not gonna happen. I will finish this probably after next year, and use it for next year's Christmas. But it won't be for this Christmas, because who knows? If I get finished, I might, you know, finish this one and use it if I have time. Most likely, I will finish it sometime after the first of the year. So that is that work in progress. And I told you that I was using Red Heart Soft for this one. All the colors are Red Heart Soft. So that is another work in progress. The next one that I have on the needles is a sock head hat. Yes, I was crazy to cast on a sock head hat. I was like everybody else making one. Why shouldn't I? This was some yarn that was just laying around in my stash. I'm trying to get it untangled here for you. Let me try. Okay, because I had the yarn wrapped around it. Anyways, this is a yarn. This is Patton's yarn, fingering weight sock yarn. And this is what the colorway looks like. Focus for me. Okay, my camera is not wanting to focus for me today. There we go. So that's what it looks like. It's purple, blue, lime green, this purple mauve color. But yeah, I've just got, you know, the ribbing started. I think you have to knit like 4 inches, so you got a ways to go. But yeah, you know, it's a nice slouchy hat. This is knit on my Knitter's Pride's US 2.5 3.0 millimeters, and these are carbons, by the way. And the yarn, I know it's Patton, so I'm not sure what the colorway is. I think, because I don't even have the ball band anymore, but I'm sure I can find it, but the color, name of the colorway is online. These were originally, or this yarn was originally monkey socks last year, and this is the yarn, and a cake. I had frogged it because I didn't have the right size needles, and I was trying to knit the sock. I don't know how I was trying to knit it, but anyways, it turned out to be too small. Like, I had knit it top down. I had knit it top down, and it was not getting on my foot. It was not going over my heel. I know that much. It was super, super tight. So I frogged it, and I was like, hey, I can use this to make a sock head hat. So that's what I'm doing, and I'm excited for that to be coming along. Okay, so last work in progress. Is that the last work in progress? Yeah, this is the last work in progress. And this is my Asking for Roses shawl. It is a paper pattern. This is what it looks like. Isn't that pretty, y'all? Yeah, that is pretty. Very pretty. And sorry, my printer is running out of ink, so the color is not the best. But I cast this on just the other day. I had gotten further along in the pattern, but somehow I managed to lose stitch count, so I ripped it all out. And the thing is, I was so mad at myself because I painstakingly cast it on using the cable method, which took me a good 30-35 minutes to get the proper stitch count that I needed. And what it is, I've always used long tail cast on. When I learned the long tail cast on, that's what I've been using for majority of my projects. So, thing is, when it comes to using the long tail cast on and I have a large stitch count, I always run out of my tail. So, if you guys know, like, a way to calculate how much yarn I will need, I think I tried to do it. Well, I tried to do it, and I think I did it the wrong way. So, I'm not sure what I did wrong. Anyways, I majored in, I didn't major in math, but majored in nursing, but I was great at math, so I don't know why I'm not able to figure this out. But I tended to do that, and I ran out of yarn. I ran out of my tail. And, yeah, I was like, you know what, bump this. I'm just going to finish out my cast on with the cable cast on. That's what I did, and you can't really tell. And I haven't gotten back to the spot I was. It's really not even worth showing you guys because it's just, like, 2 rows. So, just gonna flash it. That's all I have. That's just all I have. Yep. Just a little bit. It was a little bit. I think I had 8 rows. And it would have been worth showing you. But I don't have 8 rows anymore. I have to work my way back to where I was. But the yarn is Knit Picks again. You see the pattern here? Pattern with my needles size. A lot of my projects call for US size 6. And this is Wool of the Andes Sport Knit Picks in the Forest Heather colorway. I'm trying to get it to focus. Okay, I guess my camera's just gonna be picky today. But this is what the yarn looks like in this game. So that is that. And I told you the needle size. So that was all of my knitting. Moving on to enabling, I have something very, very pretty to show you guys this week. And I actually got this on yesterday. It was waiting for me when I got home from work. And this is Yarn vs. Zombies. This is my very first purchase from them. And I love it. This is what it is. Got the blues, greens, pink. Lime green is really, really pretty. Trying to let it focus for you guys. But yeah, that's the yarn. It's Yarn vs. Zombies. It is the wispy base. 100 superwash merino, 400 yards. Very white yarn. So I'm very excited. This will definitely be a pair of socks. I'm not sure what they will be, but I will find a pattern that will work with the yarn. So that is all I have for enabling. Actually, it's supposed to be more than that. The knit picks, the yarn for the Mahoney shawl, Asking for Roses shawl, and the Jinx yarn was all enabling, but I managed to catch cast-on-itis and cast on those things before I was able to show them on the podcast. So that is the only thing that I did not manage to cast on with. Tools of the trade, I don't have anything for this segment this week. However, I do need to purchase a new ball winder. With my Mahoney shawl, I was winding my yarn like normal. And I noticed that my ball winder is not caking my yarn like I would like it to. And I had just enough yarn to do this project. Now I probably have just under the amount that I need for the project due to my ball winder. However, I was winding it and I came across a bunch of yarn vomit, was not able to get it untangled, so I had to cut that out. So I know that I lost some yardage and will most likely have to order another skein, break into another skein, because my ball winder doesn't want to wind cakes like it's supposed to. My mom got it back in, I'm not sure what year it was, but I was still in middle school when I got that. So I'm now in college, so it's been a couple of years old. I just need to suck it up and buy another one, along with some wool wash. I do have a small bottle, like a sample bottle, that I got from Knit Picks, from that order that I got for the Mahoney shawl and the Asking for Roses shawl. I did order a small 2 ounce bottle for that. I also need to get blocking supplies. I need blocking pins, a blocking mat, or I've heard that you can use like the alphabet mats that you purchase for the kids. That's great for blocking. Just the pins go right in, come out like really easy. So I'll probably get those sometime soon so that I can block the proper way. Because normally I just have a towel and I use sewing pins and pin out my project that way and steam block on the carpet. That's how I've been blocking most of my projects. Unless I try to wet block it, but I haven't wet blocked it. I haven't tried that yet. One of these days I will go for it, but steam blocking seems to be working for me right now. I like it because it's very simple and easy. So that is Tools of the Trade in the spotlight. I don't happen to have the patterns with me for these patterns that I will be putting in the spotlight this week. The first one, I'm interested. I've had the itch. I've seen everybody else do one or start one. Is a sock yarn blanket. However, I don't want to use sock yarn because I don't have that much of it. So I was thinking I'd use worsted weight. And I picked up this yarn because I like the color of it. And I was thinking I could make, just do some sock yarn squares using wasted weight yarn. And this is Patton's yarn that I picked up from, I think it was Michael's. They had a sale, and I think it was half off. So I got a couple of skeins. Sorry for the phone, guys. Someone's going to pick it up. Yeah, I think someone picked it up. Yeah, someone picked it up. Sorry about that. What was I saying? What was I trying to say? The blanket. So I wanted to, you know, have a niche to just knit a few squares, you know, every now and then, and start working on a blanket. So I think I will use this color. This color is called New Denim. Sorry, my mom's healing through the house, throughout the house. That's how we do it when somebody calls and you just went to somebody who's just yelling out through the house. I will use this color in like maybe a purplish blue, probably closer to the color that I was using for my Mahoney shawl, and maybe a dark gray. I want to use those three colors for this blanket. So that's what I was thinking for the blanket. So that will be coming up soon. I'll probably get started on it probably sometime this week. So, also I'm wanting to make fingerless mitts. I have not picked out a pattern, but I wanted to match my Zuzu's Petals cowl. I do have some left over enough to make fingerless mitts or gloves. So I will probably pick out a pattern for that. Most likely a free pattern. Because I am on budget. Can't just go buying patterns like crazy. But, you know, we're knitters. We all do it. We all have that stack of patterns on our desk or where our knitting is throughout the house, scattered throughout the house. Because we were like, oh, I want to knit that print, buy, purchase, whatever, you know, so we all do it. So don't feel guilty. I've done it too. I've got my book. I'm staring at my book right now. It's actually a notebook that I put all my patterns in that I was going to knit someday, and I eventually will. Next is another cowl. I'm into cowls right now. It's called the Flurries Cowl by Liz Abinante, and it's a free Ravelry download. I printed it, but I'm running out of ink, so that's why I didn't bring it over here. So, but it's another button cowl. I think it uses variegated yarn, and I think it's sport weight as well. So, it is very pretty. It has 5 buttons on it, I think, and I will probably be knitting that soon. I don't have yarn for it, so what am I going to do? Gonna go purchase the yarn, even though I don't need to because Christmas is around the corner. I'm gonna do it anyway. So that is it for in the spotlight. Is favorite things. What I'm reading. Absolutely nothing. Well, it's not exactly true. I read half a page since I last podcasted. Last episode I mentioned the book by Jenny Han. It was the To All the Boys I've Ever Loved. I'm still in the same spot that I was last podcast, except half a page further. And I'm wanting to read it. I just, you know, kind of set it down. I haven't really had time to read because it's not quiet enough. I don't like trying to watch TV. I don't like having a TV on while I'm reading, or Alex is normally watching TV or some cartoon of some sort. And if I turn it down, she'll have a hissy fit. So I try to keep it where she can hear it. I don't concentrate when I have TV on. I like to either listen to music really low, or have it be completely silent. But I wanted to pick up this book. I wanted to start it. I haven't started it just yet because I'm trying to get to reading it, and I just haven't had the time. This is called Ugly Love by Colleen Hoover, and I do believe this is a college setting. It's about this guy and a girl who have this undeniable attraction, and they try to act like it's not there, try to ignore it, but they have to come to terms with it. So it seems like a stinging read. So I'm very interested in it. And I have another Colleen Hoover book. I've heard she's a great author. This is what she looks like. That is Miss Hoover. That's what she looks like. So I will try my best, at least probably tonight, read a chapter or two before I go to bed, and get back into reading more. Lately, I haven't been reading I try to take a book with me to work, but I normally don't get to it because my break is either cut short or I pick up knitting and watch podcasts instead. So that's how I spend my breaks at work. Also, this could have went in Tools of the Trade, but I decided to put it with what I'm reading because it's a book. So I have my The Knitting Answer book, and this is by Margaret Radcliffe. And it says, solution to everyday problems you'll ever face, answer to every question you'll ever ask. So this is a very, very handy book to have on hand. I still use it to this day. My mom bought this back when I first started knitting. And just to go off on a tangent, last episode I talked to you guys about me knitting and that I was taught. I didn't know who taught me. Apparently I taught myself. I was chatting with my mom. And she was like, Nicole, you don't realize that you taught yourself to knit. And I kind of remember, I remember purchasing the books to learn how to knit and walk you through the projects to go through, you know, what to do. And I guess I just got it confused that someone taught me. But I originally wanted to learn how to knit and taught myself. There was a club that I joined in sixth grade. So in middle school, I went to a club that my school offered. It was the knit club, and I think what it was, where I got confused, she was just the one to, like, confirm that I was knitting right. She taught me, like, the different styles of knitting, how people knit, all that kind of stuff, English versus continental, how to hold yarn, all that kind of stuff. So she was just, you know, reinforcing what I had already learned. But I don't know why. I guess that's why I had it in my head that somebody taught me. But I originally, taught myself to knit. But anyways, side tangent. But this book is absolutely great to have on hand. Sometimes I'll look at patterns and be like, I don't know what that means. And then I'll look it up and be like, oh, I remember. You know, so just like, you know, when you take every type of math and you look at something that is so simple and you don't know how to work it. So that kind of has a similar feel. Another book she bought me this last year. It is the Fleece and Fiber Source Book, which has more than 200 fibers, or over more than 200 fibers from animal to spun yarn by Deborah Robson and Carol Eucarius. Completely apologize in advance if I totally just butchered your name just now. But this is the book. This is a great book to have on hand. I'm wanting to learn how to spin in the near future, so I hope that. Well, I know that this will help me learn the fiber, but it's just nice to learn about, you know, the different fibers all over the world. I love this map that's in the beginning. Sorry, I'm still trying to get used to the left and right thing. And the pictures are really nice and enlarged shape on my pages. This one is Shetland. I heard people like to spin that yarn a lot. So there is some of what the books look like, what the book looks like inside. But yeah, I look through this, you know, in my spare time when I have time to look through it. You know, just read a couple pages, learn some information on different fibers and fleece. So you know. Learning about sheep is totally not weird. Not in the knitting world. Non-knitters just don't understand. Okay. So, also, favorite things, TV shows. I wanted to update you on what I'm watching. First, starting with a show that I got hooked on Netflix. I found it on Netflix. It's called Salem. And it is about, it's loosely based on the Salem witch trials. I really love that time period. Back in high school, we read The Crucible. I think I read it either my sophomore or my junior year in high school, and I enjoyed it. I liked reading about the witch trials and, you know, what had happened, and I kind of like stories that are kind of loosely based on that. So that's what that whole series is about. I think it came out earlier this year, back in April. Yeah. So I caught up on it. I watched the entire first season in like a couple of days. and it was really good. I do recommend watching it if you're interested in that time period of history. Also, I've been watching The Walking Dead. I am caught up. I need to catch up. I think I just need to watch the last episode on that show, Rain, which comes on the CW. That is historical fiction type TV show. I love the actors and actresses in that TV show. And I'm caught up. Yeah, I'm caught up. I tried to get into it last year, but I just didn't really get into it. I think I may have heard about it, and I was like, I need to watch that. And I never got around to it. So this year, I got into it, and I have enjoyed the first season, which I've caught up on Netflix. I'm like a Netflix junkie. I'm always looking for new TV shows to watch. So I've caught up on that. I have been watching American Horror Story. I think I need to go back and watch the last episode because I think I fell asleep on it. So I do like that a lot. I got into that this year as well. When I started watching The Bates Motel, I got into American Horror Story and have been hooked ever since. And again, this is another TV show that I tried to watch last year and just was like, I kept watching the first episode because I was just busy and I never got into the first episode. So I finally got into it and I actually liked it. The first two seasons I've not watched the Covenant series, which was the third season, and what's on now is the fourth season. So I always am recording on my DVR, so to catch the episodes that I miss when I'm at work. Also, Jane the Virgin, which comes on the CW as well. I absolutely love this. It's a comedy, and it's about this girl. I'm not really into spoilers, you guys know that. But I'm going to tell you what is going on so far in the TV show. It's one that I really make sure that I catch up on, make sure that I'm caught up on. It's about this girl who she just has her whole life planned out, whole life ahead of her, and she's getting engaged, or she's engaged, about to get married. She gets engaged, and she one day in the beginning of episode one, I started watching it when episode 3 was out, when I heard about it. I think I was watching Rain, and they showed previews about it, and I was like, hey, I want to watch that, so it sounded very interesting. And I think it comes on Mondays, too. Monday nights at, I think, 9 or 10 on the CW, something like that. I'm not sure. Don't take my word for it. But anyway, she goes to the doctor for a pap smear. And another lady goes to the doctor for artificial insemination. Well, the doctor that she normally sees is out, I think, on vacation. And I guess that the doctor that she does see, she just had a lot going on, and, you know, her assistant tells her, you know, she comes into work, her assistant tells her, you've got a pap smear in room such and such, and you've got a artificial insemination in the other. So what does she do? She flip-flops them, and Jane is the one who gets accidentally inseminated with someone else's sperm, and she gets pregnant, and she has to deal with that. So that's all that I'm going to tell you, but it's very interesting. It's quite hilarious. It is narrated, too. They have the narration in there, but with this guy that does it and catches you up every time you watch a new episode. And I love her mother and her grandmother. They are the funniest. And there's a bit of a storyline with her mother when it comes to Jane's father. But yeah, she's still a virgin. However, she's just artificially inseminated with somebody's sperm. So that is quite a storyline, don't you think? The next one is How to Get Away with Murder with Viola Davis. She is an amazing actress. That's all I'm going to say. You have to watch the episode. They are very, really intense. I love like CSI, Criminal Minds, Law and Order type stuff. So I'm really into that show as well. I took criminal investigations, I think it was called. I forget the name of the course. Anyways, I took that back in high school. It was my junior year I took that, so that was interesting. But yeah, I keep wanting to, I think there's like one more episode, which comes on this Thursday, and we finally get to find out who killed her husband, because I've been dying to know who killed her husband. The next one is Scandal. I am completely caught up on this one. I caught up on the entire previous season. I just have this thing, like, if I know I'm, like, a show, like, an episode or a season behind, I will not watch it until I'm caught up. So, I'm caught up on the previous season and this season. And by the way, Thursday is a new Friday. It is. Because I think How to Get Away with Murder and Scandal come on both on Thursday night. So, that's back-to-back suspense shows that are really good to watch on Thursday. Another one I've come across is Selfie. I caught a glimpse of this one night. I was sitting on the couch and I was knitting. And I caught a glimpse of it. I was like, hey, this seems like something I would be very interested in. And I think it centers around the workplace, but it's a really funny comedy. I only caught, like, I think half the episode, but I need to watch the rest of them that I've recorded. So that is one I wanted to, you know, let you guys know that I was interested in watching. And of course, Vampire Diaries. I've always got to have my vampires. I think I'm an episode or two behind on Vampire Diaries, though, but I'm trying to think. Yeah, I think it's an episode or two, because I think the last episode I watched, she makes herself forget about Damon. So, I think it was the last episode I watched. Yeah, that was the last episode I watched. And there are a few more that I have been watching that are not on here, such as, what's the show by Tyler Perry? It is If Loving You Is Wrong. I think he wrapped up that one. The next one that he has coming out is he's coming back out with, I'm trying to think, The Haves and Have Nots. That is, and it's like a soap opera type thing. That is really intense as well by Tyler Perry. I love both of those shows and a couple others that I just can't think of right now. But you can see that I'm a TV junkie. I love to catch up on my shows in my spare time because I miss them throughout the week. I wanted to take this opportunity to mention some new podcasts that I have came across. So they're not necessarily new, but podcasts that I've discovered that I don't have in my queue to watch. So starting with the Canadian Knitter, the hostess is Sarah. I think she has about 2 episodes out. Fibertown with Emily. I discovered her, I think, 2 weeks ago, shortly after I released my first episode. Knitworthy Podcast with Brianne and her mom, Linda. That is a very nice one to watch as well. Yarnder Woman with Melinda. Yarngasm. I thought that was such an interesting name to name a podcast. And your hostess with that one is Kristen. And then Beer Knits with Jen. She's interesting, too. She has different twists, you know, every podcast brings something different, you know, they have something unique that their podcast centers around, and hers is beer, and she talks about the different beers that she likes, how she ventured out into beer and all that kind of stuff. So that was really neat for her to tie in her love for beer with her knitting, and she's a crocheter too. And then the one that I absolutely adore is Come Knit With Us. With Sam and Kimmy. Those two are the dynamic duo. They are just hilarious and so fun to watch. I love their segments. They are just so creative and funny. If I had my beverage here, I would do my little towards them. But I know that I think I was reading in their thread, they do that to pay homage to a friend of theirs. I don't think they came up originally with it, that they did, I'm sorry, but I think they do it to pay homage to a friend of theirs that originally started it, but they are a joy to watch. So that was all the podcasts that I came across this week. Since I've last podcasted, I will try to keep that up, because I'm always trying to venture out and do, you know, see other podcasts. It's like I got to have every single one on my list, but I have an ever so growing podcast list that is just out of this world, and it's like I need to get caught up on all the episodes, and I try to do that every so often throughout the week. So that was all the podcast. Next is a new segment which I am entitling Everyday Life, and if you are interested in knowing how I got all that knitting done, I'm about to tell you. I got summoned to do jury duty last week, November the 3rd. is when I had to come in. I'm sorry, it was my phone that went off. Yeah, I got called to do jury duty last Monday, and it was a very interesting process. I'm only 20 years old, so I never thought that this would ever happen to me in my entire life. Everybody tells you it's your civic duty, that you have to serve on jury duty when called, and I just never thought I would be one of the ones to have to go through this. But it was very interesting. It was a great learning experience to see how they pick jurors and, have a jury pool and being on certain panels and the type of questions that they ask you and things of that nature. So it was definitely a learning experience. I only got called to come in 2 days out of that week, so it wasn't too bad. A friend of mine had also been summoned to do jury duty, and she previously in the year, and she told me that, it's just going to be hours of waiting. So when she said that, I came prepared. The first day, I had I had everything. I forgot my badge though, but I had my knitting. I had make sure I have snacks, something to sip on, Netflix. I was just prepared. When I looked around the room, I just felt so bad for everybody else because it just seemed like they had to watch what was on the TV in the room, which was, I think, the Today Show. And I don't watch the Today Show. I typically watch Good Morning America. That's the show that I like to watch in the morning when I'm getting ready in the morning for work. But yeah, that's how I was able to get all that knitting done. I worked mainly on I'm drawing a blank right now, and I'm staring at it. The Zuzu's Petals cowl and my Mahoney shawl. And I think I knit a few rows on my sock. So yeah, I was able to get a lot of knitting done while I was waiting. Where my local courthouse is it located in a square, which is pretty cool. So I never really hang out down there, but I enjoyed myself. I was able to, was in the area. I went to lunch at a local panini bar or panini place, and it was super good. The sandwich I had was amazing. It had this pickled relish on it, so that was really good. But yeah, the 2 days that I was there, how it worked was you would call in after work hours, which was 5, so they'd let you would call in after 6, 5 or 6, listen to the voicemail, and they let you know which panel needs to come in for the next day. So that's how that worked. And I enjoyed myself. I did not get picked for a case, but hopefully if this ever happens to me again, I get put on an interesting case. That's all I ask. I don't want it to be some boring case that you just have to get through. But yeah, other than that, I've been busy with work, being a mother, and doing the daily stuff that I do when it comes to outside of work, stuff like that. I think that's all that I have. Work life is good. I've only been working there for about a month now. Love my coworkers. I'm loving that I'm getting to know them a little bit better. It's always good to have a good group of coworkers. Plus, I'm the type of person that likes to do hoodie bags when the holidays come around, or bake stuff and bring it for work. So it's good to have good people that you can do that for. Let's see, knitting's life is more than good, as you can see. I got all that knitting done and a couple of finished objects. They just flew off the needles. Let's see. Oh, when we had the daylight savings time is over, which saddens me because I like to be able to look outside and it be 8 o'clock, and it's just now getting dark. Nowadays, it will be 6:30 and almost dark, or 6 o'clock and it's almost dark outside. And I've been wanting to podcast, and that has been my main reason. Instead of using this artificial light, which is the media room of the house, I use the natural light, which I think worked out a lot better in the previous episode. I liked how that turned out with the natural lighting. So push on the shove, I'm not going to get up early in the morning for work or before I start my day in podcast. It's just not going to happen because I sleep in probably till 8 or 9. Yes, I said sleep in. I'm not really early bird person, but I try to at least get up and start my day around 8 or 9 o'clock. And because most days I either have to get up and go to work in the morning or I have to go to work later on in the day. And there's stuff that I have to get done before I go to work. But I just didn't want to podcast because of I was losing my light. Whenever I needed to podcast, whenever I wanted to, it was either not quiet enough or I didn't have my lighting. So I do apologize for the lighting. It isn't the best. But hopefully when I replay it, you know, go back and edit, it's not too bright. Because it is pretty bright in this room right now. It's just in your face right now. But that is it for the everyday life segment. Podcasting and or the future of this podcast, I'm very excited. I'm so proud of myself that I went ahead and just, look, I'm just going to put an episode out there and see how it goes. You guys gave me great feedback. I greatly appreciate it for everybody that got in touch with me again on Ravelry or, you know, I was able to see it, you know. It's just so touched. The knitting community is just amazing. And I guess I wanted to start a podcast to help me with my knitting goals. Especially when it comes to, like, venturing out to new patterns, new techniques, different yarns, knitting styles, things like that. So I think that's going to really help me with my knitting goals as far as that goes. And I plan to keep up the two-week schedule of recording. I think this one, you know, just life got a little crazy. So that's why I am putting out this episode so late. But, wow, gosh, the time just blew by. I'm just not looking at how much time I've been talking to you all, and I'm a little over an hour, longer than my last episode. I can see how these tend to stretch out and you not even know it. But that is it. That is all I have to share with you guys. I just want to say, you know, thank you again for welcoming me into your home. And again, continue with the good feedback that I am getting. I love it, absolutely. If you have any suggestions, feedback, comments, to, you know, questions or anything like that, feel free to ping me on Ravelry or leave a comment below on YouTube. I am on YouTube as Little Blue Fish. So, you guys, I think I got it taken care of. I think I got it all figured out. I understand podcasting can be a little troublesome sometimes, so I tip my hat to you, to the ones that do what you do. So I'm just getting out there, and I'm looking forward to the journey that I have ahead of me. So just keep looking at my notes to make sure that's all I had to talk to you about. I think that was it. There's something that I wanted to say, but I'm drawing a blank. Oh, I am thinking of maybe starting doing a knit along. I know it's my second episode, but why not? I'm thinking about doing like a New Year's, you know, first of the year knit along, and I'm not sure what it will be. Maybe like cold weather garments or something like that. But, you know, I will talk about that a little bit later on in the episodes to come, as well as prizes and things like that. So I'll get that all set up and have that posted in the thread. If you guys want to do suggestions, head on over to the Ravelry group, the Little Blue Fish video podcast Ravelry group. Just pop in suggestions there in the thread. I'll be sure to re-upload my first episode under this name in the thread as well. So thank you again for taking the time out of your day to sit with me and discuss knitting and a few other interesting things. And I hope that you guys get one. I hope that you guys, you know, get cranking on your Christmas knitting. You guys can do it.
But I think that is about it. So thank you guys for again welcoming me into your home. And until next time, I hope you guys have a great day and happy knitting. Bye, guys.